I was complaining about him at the lunch.
Sorry. I'll be right back.
Go ahead, check.
Okay, they're gonna take your phone, they're gonna hook it up to a machine, download the information. It doesn't take a whole lot unless you got a lot of stuff on there.
I don't know what's on there. I have to use the bathroom.
Okay, no problem.
Is there,
Yep.
Is it close by?
Yeah, it's right, it's real close by. Okay, you can leave your stuff there, it's not going anywhere, and I'll ask you right around the corner here, okay?
Okay.
Do you want some water after that?
Okay.
Okay.
Can't leave.
Not yet. You got somebody here?
Seriously? Okay, I'll hold it.
Sorry.
It's okay.
We just have to eliminate everything, okay? You know what she's saying, right?
I'm assuming I'm a suspect.
No, you're not a suspect. I'm not, I don't consider you a suspect. I asked you to come up here. You came up here voluntarily. I'm not Reggie Miranda. You are not under arrest. You are the closest thing to family that I have to Daniel right now, okay? You are.
I'm so sad for, I was thinking about something else. He told me that he comes, we have week on, week off, but on Wednesdays we do an overnight.
Right.
And he told me that he might have some work up in New York and he might not be back in time for the Wednesday overnight. So there's no way that he did this because he had all kinds of plans like for next week.
You're saying he would not hurt himself?
No.
Okay, all right.
It wasn't him.
Okay. He has no reason to hurt himself or anything like that.
No, I mean, okay. I can see him being really sad when we first got divorced.
Right.
But now, he's got Amy, and he loves those boys.
Okay.
And things were really good for him. There's no way he did this to himself.
Okay. I believe you.
Which really scares me because it means there's someone out there that's willing to do this to him, and I'm scared for the kids.
I understand. You're. I understand.
And they're at school right now, and I want to.
There's an officer at the school.
Okay.
The kids are fine.
Okay.
Okay. There's no.
I'm gonna tell them.
Well, we're gonna help you with that, okay? But here's what I have to do right now, and I'm just trying to. I want to get this down, Pat. I know you don't have your phone to refer to.
Okay.
But that's okay.
You'll have all that information.
Right, because I'll check that against what you tell me.
Okay.
Your last phone conversation, okay, let's, your last personal contact, in other words, in person with Daniel, was when?
He goes by Danny.
Danny, okay.
No one calls him Daniel.
Yes. I don't know him, so I'm sorry.
I'm just telling you so that it just feels really impersonal. My last face-to-face contact with him, wow. We do a lot of like leave off pickup at the school, right? Where one of us will take the kids to school, the other one picks them up. When was the last time I saw him? I definitely saw him when I picked the kids up. I feel like there's something since then, but that would have been.
No, I'm on a way. I'm not familiar with the.
I'll get Annie because she wanted it before.
Yeah. And that was that morning I drove down, so that was June 30th.
Okay.
Whatever that Monday morning was that we drove down to Miami, I saw him, I met Amy. Then we did a lot of Skype, like we'd Skype every day while I was gone. But that's not a person. I came back with my parents. We drove back all together. And then that Friday, which would have been last Friday, a week from today. So if today's the 18th, it was Friday the 11th. That's my other brother's birthday. And I would have seen him, but I had been with the kids for like 12 days straight, and I was getting really sad at the idea of drop off of Danny coming to pick him up. And so my folks said, you know what, why don't you just, so at about 4:45, I just went over a friend's house. I didn't see him that day. And then he had the kids, and I got some sort of laryngitis, and I was alone all weekend, so that was Saturday, Sunday. And then this week, I missed the kids, so I visited them at school on Monday and Tuesday.
They were staying with Danny?
They were with Danny that whole time, but Danny and I had started on days when we really missed the kids. We'd go have like lunch with them or breakfast with them. So I went and had lunch with them or read them a story. I saw them Monday, I saw them Tuesday. Wednesday was my overnight. And so so that was Wednesday. And then he had them Thursday, was yesterday. Yeah. So that was the last time I had face-to-face contact with him.
Was?
June 30th.
June 30th, okay. And then yesterday, y'all were conversing on text about this phone call or about this discussion for Ben.
An email, I think, okay. About we'd both spoken with an administrator at the school. And so yesterday morning, I said to him, I emailed him and said, I'd really love for him to go to this school. I think we should accept it. Here's why. And then I asked him a second question about Ben's birthday coming up because I didn't have Ben on his birthday. And he wanted this Lego thing, and I wanted to make sure that no one else got it for him. So I asked him if he was going to do a party for Ben, so I knew ahead of time whether people would be bringing presents or whatever, and so I knew whether he would have gotten it from someone else or whether I should buy it for him. And he wrote back and said, when your voice feels better, let's talk, because my throat was really hurting. He said, let's talk, we need to work this out for Monday. And I sent him an email, you'll see it, sometime this morning while I was home working on my paper that said, okay, I'm ready to talk whenever you are. I don't know what time I sent it, but if I called him at 11:40, it was either before I called him, because I thought normally he would have called.
Okay.
Like when he said I'm done with the class at 10:30 and I had said, okay, let's talk, and then sent him a call or an email, like, I thought it was weird I hadn't heard from him, but I just thought, like, well, maybe he's busy with something or showering.
But he told you at some point that he was going to premiere this morning.
Yeah, no, that phone message says, I'm going to premiere, I'll be out 10:15, 10:30, and so let's... You can call me after that.
When did you receive that phone message?
Maybe after the repair guy left. So maybe at like, this morning, okay. Like at 11-ish or something.
Okay. All right. So you're at your house with the repairman. He leaves. You go back to working on your papers. And then you leave your house around noon, drive down, Trescott's blocked. You turn around, you go back around on Benton. And then you go
to the... There's a tree.
Right. Pardon?
I thought it was like a tree that fell down or something.
Right. So.
I didn't even think, like, that's the house. I saw a few houses blocked off and I just. I'm sorry, I wasted my time.
No, you're not wasting my time. I think I asked you before, you don't have a number for Amy. You do not have a contact number for her. But you know she's a professor at NYU.
Yeah.
You know that her and Danny have been seeing each other, and that she stayed here from the end of June to the 1st of July. Just
at least
28
days, maybe. Yeah.
And she met the children.
Yeah, she met a few friends in town, too.
And you don't know anything about her ex?
No. I know she was married.
Right.
And
she has children?
She has a son.
In New York?
In New York.
Okay.
She's a son. I think he's 14.
Okay.
Do
you know how old Amy is?
She's 50.
She's 50?
Yeah. She doesn't look 50. She's very beautiful. She is, not that you can't be beautiful at 50, but she looks really young. She's very pretty and accomplished. And
You know her date of birth?
I only know that she is 50. I don't, because I was looking her up one time, really.
Okay. Okay, so she's 50. She goes by Amy Adler.
Her middle initial is M.
M, okay.
So that, like, if you looked her up on the law school website, you'd find her that way.
Okay.
Her brother's a famous, he's like a famous fashion designer, so I think they spend a lot of weekends like in the Hamptons, and she lives in the city and lives like, you know, good life.
Okay.